right, we're going to talk about the Good Shepherd today. See if we can come up with some scripture realities. I think more people need to be looking in their Bibles these days, especially politicians.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Get that on your camera, Brother John. Not only politicians.
You won't make it, Brother Dick.
Even some of these preachers, so-called preachers, they need to look in their Bibles.
Lord. The Good Shepherd.
We're going to talk about the Good Shepherd. Good Shepherd, we're going to find out that he cares for us. I guess that scripture's in Philippians. Cast all your care. Where is that?
Philippians.
I want to say 419, but I think I was wrong.
Okay, I can close to it.
He shall supply. Cast all our cares upon him, for he careth for us. Somebody else turn that over. Thank you. Ooh. You didn't think I would have had that. Such a powerful verse. But we'll find it in a little bit. All righty, praise God. So Jesus cares for us, and he has demonstrated and proven that he is a good shepherd. And what we want to do today is perhaps define the shepherd, define the fold, define the harlan or the herlin, and define the sheep. So we'll know who's playing what role in this that the shepherd is going to do. What does the shepherd do? Back in the day in the Old Testament, it says that the shepherd would protect the sheep. He'll bring them into the sleeping place, and only one way in, one way out, and that's where he would lay his body. He would lay down there overnight so that he could tell who's coming in and who's going out. And if the enemy approached, he would be willing to give his life for the sheep, if necessary. If necessary. Now, that's overnight. He gives us protection. Puts us in a safe place. Of course, we know about Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. But the deal about a shepherd is that he develops an intimate relationship with the sheep. And how many have animals, love animals, have had pets, and how many got vicious pets? That's Sister Shirley's pet. I don't know where she got it over there. It could be a pig, hog, or something. A pit bull. He won't know my voice if I came over there. But any other voice command, he would know. And as we learn here, sheep have a way of knowing the voice of the intimate one who's been intimate with them. I know my German Shepherd, he responds to my voice. If it's pitch black at nighttime and I go out there into the trash or what have you, he'll give a hey boy, what's going on? And he'll settle down, become as gentle as a puppy then, because he knows my voice. I wouldn't advise anybody else to try and use the same commands that I use on my dog, because he don't know your voice. And he, so therefore he didn't know you. Sheep, even more than that, what they would do back in the day was that to identify who the proper shepherd was for those sheep, to put them all in a, together, all the sheep together, along with different people, all that livestock together, and they would call for the shepherds to come forth and call your sheep, call your livestock to you. All the other sheep paid the voice no attention if they didn't know that voice. And so now this is how we can tell if you're not the right guy, because nobody is responding to you. I mean, none of the sheep are responding to you, so you are not an intimate shepherd or a good shepherd because they don't respond to you. Man. So they could call their herds up just by making a noise, talking to them, and all the other sheep would just come to them. Oh, yeah, they all belong to him, obviously. All the others stayed, kept doing, didn't even recognize the guy. So that's how you can tell. Now, there are shepherds who are talking, who are making noise, a lot of noise in the world, And some people are following them, but they're not good shepherds. And more people are following, and more people are following tradition, events, things of the day. And who can expound upon them the most? That's today's time, this generation. A lot of people are following tradition. They're not following the intimate knowledge of, I know my shepherd. You know your shepherd? Yeah. What color is this carpet in this house? What kind of car does he drive? All this kind of stuff. What color is his drapes in his house? Oh, I know intimate knowledge back and forth. The sheep and the shepherd, they know each other that well. That's what you call a good shepherd. So, now, here we go. The entry is the door. That's the door. And the sheep recognize the shepherd's voice. Okay, now, shepherds. Let's give a definition of a shepherd. Maybe we'll see some of his work. Shepherds, leaders. Shepherds are leaders. Or a shepherd is a leader. Our shepherds are leaders. Good example, 1 Samuel 17, 34. 1 Samuel. Is that in the Bible? Mm-hmm. 1 Samuel 17. Let's see what we have there. 1 Samuel 17:34. It says here, and David said unto Saul, thy servant kept his father's sheep. There came a lion and a bear and took a lamb out of the flock. And I went after him and smote him and delivered it out of his mouth. And when he arose against me, I called him by his beard and smote him and slew him. Thy servant slew both the lion and the bear. And this uncircumcised Philistine should be as one of them. I'm going to kill him just like I killed that bear and that lion. Now that's what the shepherd did. That's the idea of a shepherd. He's going to go to battle. He's going to fight. He's going to go to battle. He's going to do what's necessary. There's no amount of danger that will keep him from responding to one of his sheep, to one of his that's in danger. All right, he'll do that. Let's go look at Isaiah 40, verse 10. Is that anybody? Yeah. 40 and 10. Is that right? Okay. Behold, the Lord God will come with strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. Got my work cut out for me. He shall feed his flock like what?
Shepherd.
He shall gather the lambs with his arm and carry them in his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are with him. Young. So the shepherd knows his work is cut out for him, and he has to be strong. That's what we get out of here. He has to be strong. Can't be weak. I mean, you're going to fight a bear and a lion, grab a bear by his whiskers, you better be pretty tough.
Yeah.
He's a tough dude. That's all there is to it. He's tough. He doesn't back down. He stands his ground, and he'll go after those that's coming after his people. And so he says, here we see that he's got to be strong. He's got to be strong. All right. That's the shepherd. That's the leader. That's his activity. Fold. F-O-L-D. Anybody got any idea? This fold. Not of this fold. They are of this fold. Other folds do I have to get to? Who are F-O-L-D? What's a fold? Okay, y'all. Look at this.
The fold was the corral, the place to
stay. The fold is the place to stay.
Okay.
That's the place stay. Call the fold. I bet you're going to be looking for a shop today. Might pick that out.
Yep. Right away.
All right, got to get ready to work. Fold is the place to stay. That's what the shepherd would do. He'd gather up all the sheep and bring them to the fold. And it was one way in, one way out of the place to stay, called the fold. And the shepherd would lay there. It's called the entryway. There's another place like that. Guess what that's called? That run. One way in. One way out. One way you get in is through the what? Shepherd. It's called the door. The entryway could be called the door. The entryway to the fold, the place to stay. The fold, the place to stay. Sheep goes in there. That's why Hebrews 10:25, I do believe, is so important for today's sheep, is that you get in the fold, the place to stay, where there's other sheep moving around. We might get touch around a little bit later. The fold, the place to stay, all right? We're moving right along. Hireling, H-I-R-E-L-I-N-G. Somebody identify him. The hireling. We can be talking about these folks. We got to know who they are.
Hired help.
Hired help. That's easy. He's the hired help. He's not the shepherd. He assists the shepherd. And the only reason why he's around is because he's getting paid.
Amen.
To assist the shepherd. He don't love the sheep, could care less about it. Just a J-O-B. Just a J-O-B. And Jesus identified him. And if you try to make something else out of the hireling, you just is trying to make an apple out of an orange, an orange out of an apple. It just doesn't work. The hireling does what he does, and that's what he does. You pay him, he watches over. Okay, Mr. Shepherd, you lay down and go to sleep. I'll watch, take care of him, I'll feed him. Where you want me to move him to? Which one you want me to call him? All like that. Mm-hmm. Now, the sheep knows him. Mm-hmm. They know him. Intimately acquainted with him. But he knows them, but he's, the only reason I hang around is because I get paid. That's the heart.
Don't pay me, I'm gone.
But he does assist the shepherd.
Yeah.
He does assist the shepherd. Here's an interesting bunch. Did I tell y'all who he's going to talk about? We said the shepherd, the leader. The fold is the place to stay. The hireling is the guy who gets paid to help the assistant, to assist the pastor. And he is helping the sheep. Let's identify those rascals. Interesting bunch of folks. One thing we do find out about the sheep is that they are what? Dumb.
Yes.
Dumb as rocks. And that ain't me. Yeah, that is you. That's us. That's us. Sheep is dumb. And they need all the help they can get. All the help. You cannot leave them on their own. No. They can't figure it out. They'll go anywhere and do anything if there's not a shepherd there helping them out. They're just as dumb as rocks. If you don't believe me, Isaiah 53:6, one of my favorite places in Scripture. Yeah, right to the bear. The bear shows up. He just walks right up to the people. The lion take him up. Isaiah 53 says what we have all done. Yeah, we all identify with the sheep. Every one of you, every one of us. We have this characteristic. What is that in Isaiah 53:6? Someone got that. It says the what? About the sheep.
All we like sheep have gone
astray. All the sheep will go astray.
Everyone will go away. And the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of
us. So the characteristics of the sheep is that they will go astray without a shepherd. They will go astray. They'll turn and wonder their own way. Don't know what danger they're getting into or anything. They just wonder. So this is why it's important for a shepherd to be intimately acquainted with the sheep. I think it's Matthew, it could be probably Matthew 21. Jesus gave command to Peter. We're all familiar with it. I think that's where it is. Matthew 21. Is that where it is? Down, but somewhere it says, feed my sheep. I think it's at the end of the book of St. John. Oh, boy. We're running all over the place here, forgive me. Yeah, St. John 21. Yeah. Jesus requested of Peter three times, and starting with St. John 21 and 14. He says, this is now the third time that Jesus showed himself to his disciples. After that, he was risen from the dead. So when they had died, Jesus said unto Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than these? He said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, feed my lambs. So take care of them. Mm-hmm. Verse 16, same thing. He said unto him again, feed my what? Sheep. Verse 17, he said unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? Peter was disturbed, grieved, because he had said unto him the third time, do you love me? And he said unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee. Jesus said unto him, do what?
Feed my sheep.
Feed my sheep, because they can't feed themselves. Here we are. I've ain't been saved a number of years. Long time. Been with the Lord long time. Mm-hmm. Been nourished of the Lord long time. Take away a shepherd, I die. Take away the fold for me, the place for me to go, lay down, and be in comfort, be at rest, I die.
Pastor Lee, isn't that also a progression right there from lamb to sheep?
Okay.
Isn't that a progression there of feed?
Yeah.
I mean, milk and then up to meat.
Yeah. The book of Peter has some reference to this too. So. Just my anointed mentality. Most times I'm not. Is that what it says?
I don't know.
But it's take care of the sheep. Take care of the sheep, because without them, I mean, without a shepherd, the sheep can't make it. And he said that right there in Isaiah 53 and 6. They all go astray. They'll go astray. So they got to be in the fold, in a protected place. They got to have an entryway, someone guarding the entryway. They are subject to just going anywhere. What? Yeah, they are. Ask the shepherd over there. Sister Hill, one thing, just go anywhere. They'll call you on the phone. I'm going to another somewhere. You gonna do what? I'm going to what? What? I'm like, was this pearls looking when she talked to me the other day? I'm going. I'm like the way the earth should breathe. I'm going. those calls come in.
Yeah.
What are you talking about? It's just the sheep. What's the characteristics of the dumb? Dumb stuff. They need a shepherd, Brother Ron, but they eat dumb stuff. Sometimes they get in a mess, you gotta pull them out and leave them alone. You got the only way you can do that is that you love and you're intimately acquainted with them. You'll go after them. Jesus says, I'll leave 99, go after that one. Because there will be one that needs them. He's going to take this one. You got to have a place to bring them. That's called, this day and time, church. Fellowship. That's why Hebrews 10:25 is so important. Oh, boy. I charge to go into that. So the sheep is the dumb one. Brother Travis, the other dumb one. That's us. We're the dumb ones. Romans 3:23. I tell you what kind of mess they'll get in. Tell you the kind of mess they'll get in. Anybody got it? Romans 3:23.
All can sin.
Yeah, all sin.
And come short of the glory.
Oh, every one of them. Every one of them. Wow. See, the one thing he's got going on, he'll walk right into the bear's mouth.
The other reference was 1 Peter 5:1. The elders which are among you, I exhort to them, who am also an elder and a witness of the suffering of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory which shall reveal. Feed the flock of God,
feed the flock
which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, but for a ready mind.
Yeah, yeah. Watch them, because they're just as goofy as they do.
We'll be an example to the flock.
They go wondering. They think they got enough food for the day, they go wondering also. What's wrong with it? They're just dumb. All right. So they need what? Protection. They need protection. And that's why the entryway to the fold is one way. You can't get out and you can't come in unless you go through that entryway. And that entryway is where the shepherd beds down at nighttime. He beds down right there. And anything come up, whether a sheep's trying to get out, where you going? Get back in. Comes a big bad wolf. You can't get in. Not on my, unless it's over my dead body. Mm. All right. So that's we haven't even read the lessons. So we do have some shepherds that, and you know, like the shepherds, like I say, you know, those who know that your animal, your livestock knows your voice, and that's what the respond to. Talking to a sister the other day about her German Shepherd. I wouldn't dare go over at nighttime if I talk. What's your dog's name?
Juan.
Well, whatever it is. No. they just don't respond. They know voices. And they respond to command of the familiar voice. So, sheep do the same thing. That's how you can tell a false one. Put a false one over here at the gateway, and you got all different livestock that belongs to different owners. And just come on up, Mr. Shepherd, and get yours. I don't have to watch you, because I know they ain't coming to you unless they know you. Mm-hmm. And if none of them come to you, you are a what? False shepherd. You're lying. And there are some out here, 2021. I think John said that they're already in the world. Already here. Heard one on the television this morning. Church of the World read something. It's okay to be gay and get married and all that. It's okay. Civil rights. Got the right. Sitting up in a suit looking sharp. False shepherds. Yeah, false shepherds. So here's the deal about them. They have false voices and they major on tradition, events, things like that. That's what they major on. They get you bogged down in tradition. So what's the key? Get in the Word. Got to be nourished in the Word. That sister was reading there. Be nourished in the Word. Okay, the nourishing reality of Jesus Christ. So, now see. So we're going to sell these false, these imposters for just a minute, if I can. Well, let's just look at a true shepherd. Numbers 27. Got to read the Bible here. Numbers 27. Numbers 27. And 16 and 17. What did I think Moses is going to give a definition of a Trisha.
Let the Lord, the God of the spirits of all flesh, set a man over the congregation, which may go out before them, and which may go in before them, mm-hmm. and which may lead them out, and which may bring them in, that the congregation of the Lord be not as sheep, which have no shepherd.
Don't be like sheep that have no, that the congregation don't be like sheep that have no shepherd. So the Lord says, well, here's a good man. His name was who? Joshua. Joshua being the shepherd. What do we know about Joshua? Well, he would fight. He would fight. He fought to win. He would fight. You got to have a shepherd that will fight for you. Fight for your life. When you're in the scene, fight for your life. Fight for you. You can't win. You can't. What the hell they can't for you? They don't know how to intercede, get down, get dirty. Pastor Hill say ugly. Take care of business. They make a difference. Somebody's life's on the line. You need a shepherd to do that. Sheep only go so far. But they get tired. So put them in the fold, let them rest. Protect them. That's just the way it is. A sheep is not a shepherd. Don't try and make a sheep a shepherd. Well, we're hiring somebody to watch over. Good. He'll hang around until the yogurt hits the fan. And then he's gone. Let's see what Jesus had to say about that. Okay, John 10 and 7. Someone read that. Read verse 8 while you're there.
Then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. Mm-hmm. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, ooh. But the sheep did not hear them.
Wow, Jesus, slow down, man. Oh, wait a minute. Who are you calling a thief? Who are you calling a robber? It says, how many of them?
All
of them. And he's talking to the Jewish people. All of your preachers. There was a preacher that got up last week. He had about 10 minutes of talk. And he said, back in 1979, you could go to a church on Sunday morning, didn't have to take your Bible with you. And nobody did. Hardly. I went to a church like that. And if I visited another church, it was like that. And they had the theatrics, ladders and stuff. And climbing and swimming from chandeliers, and emotions swimming all over the place. And nobody gets saved, and nothing like that. And the guy, he's at his first brotherhood meeting, and it was reading about Abraham and Sarah, and what was Hagar, she appeared, and they said, oh yeah, that's all right, that was okay. That's it. Abraham should have been, I'm just as raw as I could be, reading the word. He said, I don't think that was right. And I got pulled up for the fellowship. I was just reading, yeah, I don't think that was right.
Until you scouted upon it, then it made you
So, okay, now, all that ever came before me are thieves and robbers. But the sheep did not work.
They don't hear.
They don't know that stuff what you're talking about. They don't respond to you. Okay. Now, verse 9, very heavy verse. I am the door. I am the door. Remember that's that entryway. It's called the door. I am the door. By me, if any man do what? Enter in. And that's a big if. If any man come in through the door, he shall be, by the word says, saved. That means he will obtain salvation, spiritual nourishment. And he will go in and out and find pleasure, or pastor. Pastor means he's continually being fed spiritual realities, spiritual truths about his Lord, about his salvation. If he continues, go in and out. Church, go home. Church, go home. Church, go to work. Go home. Church, go to work. Church to the bone. Church office. Go in and out. Mm-hmm. Finding pastor. He's nourishing himself. But there's some that don't do that. They go and they never hit the door. Why do they do that? The sheep, they're dumb. They're just dumb. They go astray. What's supposed to happen to these dumb ones out here? Well, gotta send a shepherd out here. We'll get them. I'll leave 99 in the phone and we'll get that one dummy. Well, here's the reality again in verse 10. The thief does do what? The thief comes to do what? Now, it's the thief. Is he the harlot? It's the thief, the harlot.
No. Not necessarily.
No.
Not necessarily. No, the harlot is not. The harlot is true to his work.
Yeah.
Until the younger come hit the fan. Yeah. You know I'm leaving when the wolf comes. I'll feed you and give you some water and lay you down. But you know when the danger comes, I'm leaving. So don't mischaracterize me. Don't be mischaracterizing me. I'm leaving when the stuff gets bad.
You're not paying me enough for that.
That's right. My life is not part of the deal.
Also, there's no room for advancement from the hiring.
That's right.
Can't go up to be a shepherd.
He's just there for the pay. So he's not the thief. So who is the thief?
The wolf.
Yeah, wolf. Your known enemy. Your known enemy. You know him, right? And it's amazing how we saints just walk right into him. That's the bear. So he goes to sheep right up there to him. Sneak his head in his mouth. He don't have enough sense to run and get away from him. So he's got to be protected, he's got to be nourished, got to be fed troops all the time so he can be aware. Now, I'm telling you, there's a lot of people that don't know, I don't have good nourishment, so it's okay if I marry Brother McClellan over there. Well, I'm all right. You know, this is okay. They say it's okay. They're not nourished in the Word. I sincerely believe they'll stand for it because they're not nourished in the Word. And they even use the Word to justify something. So they've come to steal, kill, and destroy. I'm come that they might have what? Life. But they might have it more what? Abundantly. Somewhere in Hebrews 11:6 has a play in this. We've got to look at that. Yeah. Okay. Here it is. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is. So when I get salvation, I got to really believe. And as I'm into my believing, going through that entryway, what happens to me? I get rewarded for going in and out. Woo! I get rewarded for coming back, getting some more nourishment. I'm taking it and going out. And coming back, getting some more nourishment. Get rewarded. Seeking spiritual truths, reality about my life. You get rewarded. Those that are diligent about it. Yeah. Picking two subjects in a year, you only make 12, I would not call that diligence. Yeah. 52 subjects in a year, you only make 30, I would call that diligence. So I've been involved in this. You ain't coming back getting enough nourishment often enough. You're getting fed television. maybe sports, maybe the Young and the Restless, Sex and the City. Some of these things. It's on TV. We're going to fed some of these things. Nourishment. Okay. So Jesus says, I am
the view.
No. Yes, we have.
On the view, or something is on. Crazy stuff on TV. Crazy stuff on TV these days. I am the Oprah. People in the Oprah. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd does what?
Give his life.
Give his life. But he that is a harlot, which all he does is sell tradition and events and all that kind of stuff, he's not the shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, see the wolf coming and leave the sheep. That's what the harlot would do. I see danger. Don't even warn me. I'm just gone. And runs. And the wolf catches them and scattered them. Matthew 7:15. The wolf will catch them and scatter them because there is no shepherd.
Wow.
Is it
7:15?
Matthew 7:15. We have that there. All right. Uh-oh. What do you say? Beware.
Of the false prophet.
Come in what kind of clothing?
Sheep clothing.
Beware. So you just can't believe everything you want. The sheep know the right voice. And they'll come, man. They'll come selling you tradition, events, et cetera, all this, everything. Everything but the word. And it's amazing to me how many people buy what they sell. Lord, did you get anything? Did you see that event? Yeah. You see that car? He was in. Ooh, you see how he preached about prosperity. Ooh, honey. You see that prayer line he had? Ooh, wait. You hear his prophesying? Ooh, wait. And everybody's all caught up.
But they get led astray because they haven't come in and out of the fold enough to know the Lord.
They just know the evangelist come to town. Big meeting going on. Sheep, what are they doing? They just follow me. They don't have to go astray. Why do they go astray? Because they're dumb. I'm dumb. I need nourishment. Else they'll fall for anything. Who? Verse 13. Harlan, he runs because he is a what? That's what he is. That's what he is. And he does not care. And somewhere in that scripture, I wanted to say somewhere in Philippians, cast all your care upon him because he does what?
Care. 1 Peter 5:7.
That was that first, that's why it is. 1 Peter 5:7. Cast all your care upon him because he cares for you. All right. I'm the good shepherd and what?
No, my sheep.
And they what?
They know me.
And that's the deal right there. Intimacy. If you miss out on the intimacy with the Lord, you don't know him. Yes, sir.
Brother Lee, just kind of sitting and thinking about something. A lot of times we teach our children a lot about being a leader and not a follower.
Right.
And I wonder if in reading this, could there be confusion with them in that regard, you know what I'm saying? Or even with adults,
you know? Yeah. You want to be, especially children, you want to teach them not to just follow the crowd, and which is the majority of whatever is most of the time. The opinion, the get in the car with the teenagers, get in the car with your buddies on prom night. It's been drinking. That ain't too smart.
I think it's an alpha for that would be, though, if you're teaching your kids, principles, the good things, if you're raising them in the way they should go, then the t- teach them that they should be leaders, then you know that they're, you know what they're going to do. Right. You know what your son's going to do. You know what your daughter's going to do. Right. So if they have friends, have your friends follow you. Don't follow them.
Right.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. I'm always telling my kids, always, you know, need. Uh-huh. Don't let nobody tell you what to do. Yeah. You do what you were taught.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Strong principles. And they got to be, they have to really buy into what you're teaching them, because you are there the next thing to a shepherd. You know, that's it. Dad's been protecting and feeding and nourishing me, and everything he's saying is good. Coming out, seem to be all right, you know, and then they can buy that. But say like you the shepherd, and you smoke, drink, curse, and all that, and say, don't do as I do as I say. They won't buy into it. And then soon as the challenge come up,
you
thought about
dad to do.
Yeah. So you have, and then, so the shepherd would lay down his life. You know, they have to see that you sold out to what you believe in. And majority of people are not sold out to what they believe in. Oh. Let's watch the political stuff coming out. I mean, that's the most.
In verse 14, it says it there.
Is that 8:14 or
what? Verse 14.
Oh, okay.
Lesson.
Okay.
Back in the lesson.
Okay.
I am the good shepherd. Uh-huh. You know, you can have a shepherd that's not a good shepherd.
Yeah.
You know, like you were mentioning earlier.
Yeah.
But the good shepherd is going to lead in the right direction.
Right.
And when you say be a leader and not a follower, you're talking about a good shepherd.
Right.
And
right.
As you mentioned earlier, that if you're doing something and say, don't do as I do, do as I say, they're not going to listen to that.
Right.
Because you teach by precept as well as example. Precept is what you're teaching. Example is what you're living.
What you're living.
Right.
Right.
And if you're not living anything, as Pastor said, a nickel worth of
temptation, or that bear, that wolf, whatever come up, they're just going to wander right with them. They don't know. They're just going to go right on. And, now here's the here is that I know mine. He says no, was that I'm intimately acquainted. I'm acquainted with each other. We know each other. Now, how many know your children? They will or they won't do certain stuff. They ain't buying certain stuff. That's, you gotta know them. They will go off the reservations on some things.
Oh, yeah.
But there's some things I know they ain't leaving the reservation on. If you can't say I know some things, they are not leaving the reservation. Then that's because you know them. But if you, it's questionable. Yeah. You know, I don't know. Then it's not enough for that intimacy. Well, hey, we know. Now you know. And that's how Jesus is with us. He know. I know. What he does know is that if you don't get in that fold, you want to be wandering astray.
That's true.
If you don't return to the fold, you don't come in and out and get some pasture.
Yeah, the wolf's going to get you.
Every time. And he said in his word that the devil wants to scatter you like what? He wants to do that. He wants to get you all going all kinds of ways. He got you. You know what the preacher said last week? Strengths in what? Numbers. He said it.
Break your arm.
Have All right, another sheep. Here's an important deal, verse 16. Well, verse 15. As the Father know me, even so know I who?
The Father.
Intimacy, we know. I lay down my life for the sheep. The Father knows me that well, that I will lay down my life for the sheep. Verse 16. And other sheep. Who is that?
Gentiles.
There you go. Gentiles. Other sheep I have which are not of this what? Oh. They don't come here. They don't come to the synagogue. They don't come to the tabernacle. They eat pork and each other. And you too if you get in the way. They're hungry enough. They do weird stuff. Peter said, I don't associate with them kind of folks. But Jesus says, it's called not what I have cleaned up.
That's right.
Be in mind. Somewhere Peter says, he has no respect of persons. But at this particular time, he's talking to this particular group of people. And then he says, I got another bunch you don't know much about. They're mine too. Mm-hmm. And I got to bring them in. See? Yes. Them I also, what? Must bring. I got to get the gospel. The gospel has got to get to them. Whoa. Who are those folks? Weirdos like that. Druggies. Prostitutes. Yes. Pimps. Thieves. Liars. Murderers. Don't know nothing. Never heard nothing. Jesus says we got to get to them. I got to bring them too. I must bring, and they shall hear my voice.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And then I will make it one fold and one shepherd. A lot of end times in verse 16. A lot of end time revelations in verse 16.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, that's why my Father loved me. Because I'm bringing everybody in. That's why my Father loves me. Because I do what? There's not one other shepherd that meets that qualification. Search high and low, all around the world you can go. There's no one religion that will say, my God laid down his life for me. My Lord laid down his life for me. Where is your certification, certificate, testimony, whatever you got, Mr. Buddha witness, Muhammad witness, JW witness, you name, where is your certification? Where is it written that your God said he would lay down his life for you? Ain't nowhere in all of the universe someone can make that claim. But in Christianity. So everybody else come whistling Dixie, they just tweet thieves and robbers. False prophets. And John said, they're already in the world. Alright, moving right along. So therefore do my Father love me because I lay down my life that I might do what?
Take it again.
Take it again. So he's got to lay it down. I'm going to lay it down. Get in the doorway. I know the thief's coming. Here he comes. This time he will kill me. And that's when he knew the time when the thief will show up. And is this the time for me to let him kill me? Yeah, this is the time. They said, fight, come down, fight. Don't let him slap and spit on you like that. Fight back. This time, I'm letting it down. I'm surrendering. Praise God. So no man take it from me, but I lay it down of what?
Myself.
I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. So that's what the good shepherd, some of the ideals of. Let's look at Matthew 21 and 15 before we read. And scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, and the children crying in the temple. Am I in the right place?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
and saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, they were so displeased. And he said unto them, Hearest thou what these say? And Jesus said unto them, Yea, have you never read out of the mouth of babes and sucklings, thou hast ordained, perfected praise. So we praise him for who he is. He's our good shepherd. He laid down his life. He's the one to lay down his life. And we are the sheep. We're the dumb ones. If he don't feed us, we don't get nourished, we're going to die. We're going to go out there and get killed. Get destroyed. Don't look like a hireling do you. He won't do you. He just leaves. That's what he does. I'm out of here. But your enemy, your thief, the thief, he knows what. I know that's the devil. Don't just walk right outside the gate and put your head in the bear's mouth.